Smallpox eradication was one of the greatest accomplishments of the human race.
I'm sure there are literally billions of lives that have been saved as a result.
Good news from Geneva. The World Health Organization has made it official. Smallpox throughout the world has been virtually eliminated.
After eradication was declared in 1980, there were still samples of variola virus around the world. One accident, one confirmed case is a pandemic. Smallpox was still a threat.
Hospitals all over the world had blood samples and samples of scabs from people with smallpox that were collected during the course of ordinary smallpox outbreaks. But all this material was infectious.
At that point in time, the decision was to ask countries to voluntarily identify any potential stocks or materials they had and to consolidate them.
The compromise that was worked out is that the virus would be kept in two places.
One would be the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention's highest security lab in Atlanta, and the other would be the Ivanovsky Institute in central Moscow.
By shipping them to those two centers, the idea was to do some sequencing of the virus, learn as much as we could about it, and then destroy it. That was the intent.
That was the deal, that they were going to actually destroy the virus at the end of it. But that didn't happen.
Dr. Josh Lederberg, a Nobel laureate, once said, eventually the viruses will win. But actually, in the case of smallpox, I think we, the human race, won, maybe. We defeated Mother Nature. But now the question is, will a terrorist organization or a nation state cause us to have to face smallpox again?
This virus has been eradicated from the human population, so it doesn't exist, except in two labs, in Russia and in the United States.
The risk of re-emergence of smallpox has changed significantly.
We believe the WHA should reconsider this agenda item in 5 years or whenever research goals...
After smallpox eradication, there was general accord that it should be destroyed.
Everybody was fine with that in the early 90s. But then the concerns about its use as a weapon became more and more highlighted.
In the 1990s, as the Soviet Union fell, several scientists defected and started telling the Brits and us of secret weapons programs using various viruses and organisms that have been going on since the 1970s.
Now, a defector named Ken Alabek brought with him evidence that the Soviet Union had laboratories scattered from St. Petersburg all the way out to Siberia.
Ken Alabek was a Kazakhstani. He was the deputy director of Biopreparat, the offensive biologic weapons program in the Soviet Union.
Where not only were researchers developing biological weapons out of smallpox and other dangerous organisms, but perhaps more importantly, they were developing weapons systems for the delivery of viruses to human populations.
40,000 scientists and engineers making bioweapons.
They had stockpiled up to 20 liquid tons of weapons-grade smallpox in huge tanks.
They were focused on biological weapons that would have the greatest potential to cause harm to their enemies. And they saw smallpox as being on the top of that list.
Bill Clinton started looking at the bio threat in the late 90s and the details of what Ken Alabek and the other defectors said, and he got very concerned.
And what came out of that was the thought that the US is just not ready to declare the stocks valueless. So the US government took it to the World Health Organization and said, we would like to pull virus back out of the freezer and do the following types of studies.
The work was largely oriented around getting new vaccines and new antivirals.
In 1999, at the World Health Assembly, the United States put forward a resolution asking for a delay in the destruction of the smallpox stocks. And then 9/11 happened, and the anthrax attacks in the United States.
From Australia to Asia to the Americas, fear over anthrax has gone global.
This war on terrorism is going to continue for an indefinite period of time.
The arguments became much easier to retain the virus because everybody was afraid.
We were not paying much attention about smallpox. I was not in government at that point. And the Sunday after the attack, I was called to meet with the Secretary of Health, because it wasn't clear where we stood on stocks of smallpox vaccine. Somebody had the idea, I think, that there was maybe as much as 20 million doses. Turned out the figure was 90,000. 90,000 doses of smallpox vaccine for the country.
D.A. Henderson went down to the White House and went around Washington, and he basically twisted a whole lot of arms and got a whole lot of money.
We went full steam ahead. And by 18 months, we had 220 million doses.
The end result, quite quickly, was a national stockpile of smallpox vaccine so that every person in the United States could be vaccinated in the event of a national or global smallpox emergency.
We have enough doses of the smallpox vaccine, but people need to be aware that the prospect of using this virus as a biological weapon hasn't dimmed at all.